A storm just popped up out of the blue, and there it is. And I've been listening to some weather watchers or storm chasers or something on my Baofeng 2-meter repeater. Kind of interesting. I guess it's out in Warrenton, Missouri. This car, what cool colors those are. Looked to be a wall cloud earlier, but it's kind of spread apart. Stopping for coffee, watching for storms. I think that's called a shelf cloud. Shelf cloud different from a wall cloud in that it extends further. Things gaining on me. I gotta go that way and avoid it. Look at the ridge lines, they look very strange. I'm in danger of lightning right now. I should probably not be here. He's got more problems than I do. It is 10 a.m. on a Saturday in the middle of summer, and it's like it's night outside. It's like it got dark. I have to keep going though. I gotta pick up my daughter halfway across Missouri because she spent the week with grandma. I'm gonna have to pull over maybe if this light little car gets tossed around in the wind. Headlights on, 10 a.m. Rolling right over me. I don't see any wall clouds or rotation. I know a little bit about storms. I've had spotter courses before, so I know what looks tornadic, and it's a wall cloud that's rotating. Of course, that doesn't mean you're safe. Ever. Anymore. Oh shit. I should have stayed on the exit ramp. What's good is most rational people, like the people in front of me, have slowed way down and turned their hazard lights on. Visibility is the problem, and skidding, of course, is a problem. It's why you don't want to go out with bad tires, bald tires. It's a lot easier to start to skid. The water's collecting on the road. It's not that bad right now, it's just heavy rain, not strong winds. So what happened was, I know the audio is bad, but it's really loud in here. That storm, it was going east, it turned south. At least that's what my wife told me on the phone It turned south and I'm going west and it came right down on top of me. And here it is. And this car is very light. It's the lightest car I've ever owned. It gets tossed around a lot. Had I known it was going to turn south like that, I wouldn't have made this trip. Or I would have at least stopped. But it's not that bad. It's just this. It's exactly what you see. We have to go real slow. I'm following this car at about 60 miles an hour. And I'm about to drive out of this stuff, I think. I learned in driver's ed a long time ago, the car in front of you, try to stay in their tracks. You have more traction in your tires if you can keep your tires in their tracks. Out of it, clear back here. We just drove under a classic storm. Glad it wasn't tornadic. Oh crap. I gotta come through that on my way back. I passed that accident and these people are coming really fast, so I do my blinkers so they will know something's wrong. Jeez. Right. My God. That are not from the United States or don't know much about tornadoes, and I don't claim to be an expert, but what happens is the Gulf of Mexico, it pushes up a lot of warm air up into Texas and Oklahoma. Really, really warm air. Kansas, and that becomes Missouri, Arkansas, that becomes what they call Tornado Alley, where it's just like perfect conditions in the spring for tornadoes. And it's the mix, from what I understand, it's the mix of the really warm air and the cold air pushing across the jet stream and coming down from the north that creates a lot of energy. And basically rotation starts, and then within the storm that has a lot of energy, there's updrafts, a lot of winds going up, and it starts to rotate, and that becomes a tornado. And sometimes it gets strong and it comes all the way down to the ground. It's just basically a huge dust devil. And sometimes they get a mile wide. The one that hit Joplin up here was a mile wide. It cut right through the town. You could see an overhead map. It looked just like that, like a buzzsaw. Anyway, I don't know, not claiming to be expert or anything, but that's the basics of why there's so many tornadoes in our area. It's just like a perfect mix of warm air, energy, and the imbalance of cold to warm air that gets fueled by the Gulf of Mexico. It's also why it's so humid, so extremely humid in Missouri. Missouri, where we are, Midwest, you'll get... It doesn't do that thing where it just rains all day long. It does do that, but not very often. What you get are these storms, they pass through, and you get tons of rain, and then it just stops, and all of a sudden you're in the sun again. And you see, if I keep going, this road's almost totally dry, and it was only like 15 minutes ago I was in the storm. It's weird, it's just, they pass through, they don't stay.